Hey, Dr. Charles Oliver here. We have a lot of our patients come to us because we do a very specialized technique in chiropractic, and it's called chiropractic biophysics. It's an amazing technique and has probably been studied more than any other technique in chiropractic. A lot of times I find myself showing people before and after photos of some of our patients and explaining exactly what the technique's about, but we decided to create a series of videos to explain some of the before and after so that people coming into our office can really appreciate and kind of see ahead of time exactly what we do. What you see a green line and a red line. So the green line is what we call the healthy or the optimal posture or structure, and the person should have a really nice smooth curve. Now the red line, of course, is where the person is. Next set of before and after pictures and x-rays, what I want to show you, the changes that we can get in the structure in the low back. Now, a lot of times with the low back, what we're looking for is to improve the amount of arc to the spine. For instance, everybody's heard of disc problems, right? Usually with the disc problem, people don't have enough backward bending, like kind of what we call extension, or an arch would be another term, in the lower portion of the lumbar spine. And when you're lacking that, you're naturally gonna put extra pressure on the disc. Now, we work on this a lot with folks and we can get really good results. I didn't post these on our site because quite frankly, it's not that impressive just visually glancing at it. We our software program can break down the amount of curvature down to the 10th of a degree, and that's impressive. And I'm a kind of a nerd with that stuff. And when we improve that arch in the lower part of the back, the person definitely feels better and we're holding that disc in the right position. But again, I just didn't post those before and afters because glancing at it, you're really not gonna know exactly what to look at, and the results aren't gonna be as dramatic. So the videos, or the pictures rather, that I did post, these are more dramatic changes. And this is actually a finding that we see pretty commonly with the low back. A lot of times, and this goes for a lot of people who think, or they've been told that they're sway back. What they really are, their trunk is shifted backwards. So what I mean by that is the lower thoracic vertebrae, there's 12 bones in the mid back. The lowest one, T12, needs to sit directly above this bone in the pelvis called the sacrum. And a lot of times with chronic low back pain, we'll find that shifted backwards. So can you imagine the weight of your torso being shifted backwards? Well, these are models of the spinal bones. Can you imagine that? And these are the bumps along the back of your spine. Can you imagine the weight of your trunk being shifted backwards? How much extra pressure and stress that's gonna place on these joints back here? A lot. I mean, enough to where you'll probably always have low back pain if you don't change it. And so we utilize the chiropractic biophysics technique of adjustments and exercises and different types of remodeling traction to slowly stretch out scar tissue and ligaments and all types of soft tissue, quite frankly, in order to change the structure. And so what you see here in the first set of films is a patient who was shifted back. You see the green line is where she's supposed to be tracking. And you see how far backwards that red line is, that's her. So I mean, she started back considerably, I mean, several inches. And then after 3 months of treatment and following this protocol, we brought her further forward. And obviously her low back feels better than it has in years. And same thing with the second set of pictures. Shifted back tremendously, and then over the course of 3 months, brought her much closer to a neutral position. Now, both of these cases, these are extremes of when we started out. And again, these people, they have pain for years and years and years. And you know, sometimes we're the last hope or last solution. And so their treatment doesn't just stop there. There's more room for improvement. But this is just a start. After 3 months, and probably after being misaligned for years and years, it's a really great start for both of them. So I hope that you enjoyed these videos with taking pictures of the low back, x-rays, I should say. We actually will look for those big dramatic changes or asymmetries or misalignments, but we also are able to look for very subtle changes, especially in the lower part of the low back, to where we can identify even a 5 to 10 degree differences in amount of backward bending. And that's enough to put pressure on that disc and make essentially make it to where the body can never get over a disc problem, but putting that curve back in the spine can give people a new lease on life. So I hope you enjoyed the videos. Feel free to look through our gallery for more before and after pics. Have a great day.